Mavs, Nico.
General, manager. I want to do it so bad. If I touch the just camera, Chopper will kill me.
No. No. Never touch a man's camera.
Yep.
Don't touch a man's sneakers and don't touch a man's camera.
There he is, Mavs general manager Nico Harrison. Nico, thank you so much for joining us here on Twitch and on Mavs.com. How are you doing, man?
Now, you were, I don't know how many fan jams you've been a part of. I mean, there's even maybe a chance that you went to some working for Nike, but is this what you expected walking into the building today, this crowd?
No, actually it's not. Can you guys hear me?
Yeah.
Okay, perfect. I told my college roommate, he said, hey, I'm thinking about coming down, bringing my son. I was like, yeah, do it. He goes, do I need to come early? I'm like, nah, there'll be nobody down here.
You got the text
Sorry,
message.
Sorry, Omar.
Omar's texting you, hey, man, I need in. Can you come get me right now? I'm trapped outside.
What an amazing crowd. This is awesome.
You make the conference finals, and the hype is out of control.
I love it.
You know? Yeah, absolutely. So yesterday, NBA TV was on the scene, filming practice. It was awesome. Two guys that really stood out. Josh Green and Jaden Hardy. The hype is out of control. Everybody saw Jaden the Sham into the Eurostep reverse finish, lit the internet on fire. What have been your impressions of the rookie so far?
Well, the best thing about Jaden is that, you know, he struggled a little bit in summer league, but he's been in the gym ever since then, and he's gotten better and better and better, and the coaches have worked him out. He's understanding our schemes, and he's a hard worker. He has a skill set that he's just a natural born scorer. But he's learning our defensive schemes. I think he's going to be a really good player.
I think that's an interesting distinction too, Nico, because, you know, fans and media make assumptions. They go, okay, well, we lost Jalen Brunson. I wonder if the young kid can absorb those minutes. But you said it. He's not a traditional playmaker. He's a scorer as he gets out on the break here. His role when he does get minutes is to strictly fill it up.
Yeah, I think he's a natural scorer. Eventually he'll learn to play make for others, but you know, he's young. It's going
right.
to take a while. You know, he didn't go to college.
Right.
It's going to take him a while, but he's a talented player.
He's at that stage where, like, every single day he can get better at something, you know.
Legitimately.
Really,
and he lives in the gym. Like, he absolutely lives in the gym.
That's awesome to hear. The other guy, Josh Green, even after that practice, Lucas said on NBA TV, so it's out in the world now, he said, this is Josh Green's year. So what does he need to do? What does he need to improve at? Show you guys for this to be Josh Green's year.
Well, I think he's done it. You know, we talked about it coming into the summer. It was a big summer for him. And, you know, Michael Finley calls him the MVP of the summer. He lost weight. He got more confident. And he's looking really good.
We've talked so much about consistency of jumper with him, and obviously that's going to have to come. But I think back to, like, the way Jason Kidd made – Giannis a playmaker, even though he's not a traditional point guard, and the NBA has changed. Y'all are probably counting on Josh to be a playmaker for this team this year, both him and Frank.
Yeah, I think both of those guys are going to have to step up. But the thing about Josh is his confidence, and when you put the work in that he did in the summertime, it translates to confidence, and so I think he's going to be fine.
You have fun over in Germany?
I did. It was a great time.
Yeah.
I
mean,
you were getting
really
to kick it with the whole, like, Dirk family. So, yeah, the Mavs family and the Dirk family, which is kind of the same family, right?
Yep.
What was the best part of that trip?
The best part of the trip? Probably the dinner we went to. Dirk took us out to dinner the first night to have a schnitzel.
All right.
You know,
Skin, you were invited to that.
I couldn't get across the waters for whatever reason. I was stuck in Dallas. I missed out on all of that. You got some good German grub, though?
Got some good German grub.
Yeah, did y'all imbibe? Because you're at the home of beer. I mean, did you imbibe a little bit?
We had to.
You have
it's
no choice.
Yeah, even if you don't drink, you just have to do it.
You've seen a lot of jersey retirement ceremonies in the NBA, but what is it like to be one for a country like that?
Yeah, I mean, I don't think FIBA's ever retired anybody's jersey.
Incredible.
It just shows the greatness that Dirk is and how much he represented his country, you know, on and off the court, but then also in international play.
We see him at practice, too. He's got the notepad. He's got the pen. He's taking notes. What are you learning from Dirk through camp so far?
Well, the good thing about Dirk is he's obviously played this game at a high level, and he knows what he likes and what to look for. So his feedback has been amazing.
So, Nico, there's a thought that, okay, the off season is over, but – I would imagine, you know, you talked about it last year after the Porzingis trade, and you've talked about it in the offseason. Y'all are constantly looking to get better. Do you anticipate maybe some mid-season transactions being something that y'all would be looking to do? What would be the determination for something like that?
Well, first of all, this is a new team, so we got to kind of see who we are and right. where we're at. And then I think once we gauge that, then it's like, okay, how can we make, you know, it's our duty. If we can make ourselves better, we got to do that. So yeah. we got to look for that. But first, we're going to see who we are first.
I also want to ask you about we've been talking on the broadcast so far, the Wood trade. We've seen him. We know what he does. But you guys really were very interested in adding JaVale McGee as one of the primary things you wanted to do. Why is JaVale McGee important to this team?
JaVale McGee, he's a winner. He's won. He's an amazing rim protector, amazing rim roller, which is going to go great with Luka. So I just think the stuff that he'll be able to give us, second chance points, that we can use in the playoffs, I think he has it.
And what about the intangibles too? Because last year's team, guys that have been in the playoffs before, but JaVale's won three titles. I mean, he's been on some of the best teams of all time. You know, and he's familiar with Jason too. So what is all of that experience like? The intangible traits that he brings, how big of a boost can that be for everybody else on the roster?
Oh, it's everything. It's, I mean, when you talk about team chemistry and leadership, you know, he's bringing all that and he's been there. So the moment's never going to be too big for him.
Is he a vocal guy? What's his personality like?
Nah, he's not a vocal guy. He leads by example. You know, he's going to be there on time. He's going to work hard. And he's one of those guys that just you're going to follow because of how hard he plays.
I'm curious about that, too, as Maxie lets it rip. It's a soft jumper that doesn't land. I'm curious about, you know, there's an assumption. Okay, Jay Kidd wanted this because, obviously, he coached him in L.A.
Go JaVale?
Look at JaVale as we talk about it.
Let's go.
But was this Jason telling you I need this, or was this you going to Jason going, hey, we need your guy?
No, I mean – We all know what we missed in the playoffs and what we needed, and we didn't have rim protection last year or shot blocking, and so he gives us that, you know.
All right, familiarity with the Warriors system maybe too. Maybe he knows how to beat them better than anybody else.
Okay. You know? Hey, I don't know if your phone, if you're getting text messages this week, but there is a real famous Kobe story that was making its way around the internet this week about international play against Spain, in which he floored Pau Gasol to set a tone. And they're showing all these clips. And, man, Nico, you were in quite a few of those clips. Were you getting hit up this week? Is that was making the rounds? Did you know you were an internet all-star sensation?
I was getting hit up this week. That was Fat Nico.
I just look at it as jacked up Nico.
I was a little out of shape.
What can you tell us, though, about that trip and being there for a part of that?
Well, part of the Redeem team, you know, we had gone 2002, 2004, 2006, and we got spanked.
Yeah.
And it was one of those things where we all collective effort with USA Basketball, Nike, the NBA, we went out and made sure that we had the best available guys so that we could get back on the map and what we felt was our rightful place of being the best country in basketball in the nation.
What's always cool at the Olympics is that, you know, the USA team is always going to be stacked, but when it comes to winning time, they kind of defer, right? They'll go to the alpha. And for so many years, that was Kobe. Now it's, you know, maybe LeBron. But, I mean, everyone just kind of knows. Everyone knows who to give the ball to when it's winning time.
Yeah, you know, the thing in those international competitions is we're playing – the U.S. is playing against teams who have been playing together forever. You look at Slovenia, you look at Spain, Argentina. Like, those guys were raised together, have been playing together. You can't just put a collection of superstars together and roll the ball out because the separation's not that big when you're playing against really good, cohesive units.
Well, we were talking international ball. Australian Josh Green made a really nice drive and won. Bobby was talking earlier about him working on his jumper. We were talking about confidence and decision-making. What have you seen mechanically from his jump shot that looks like it may lead to improvement this season?
I think it's all confidence. I really do. I think everything he does leads back to confidence.
He's got the rock right now, and he's letting it rip.
I mean, that looks good.
And he's knocking it
down.
That's
a good-looking jump shot.
No hesitation. He's looking for it. He shoots in it, and he's confident. It's going to go in.
I appreciate just the instincts to go ahead and put his jumper on display while we're talking about him. Just a really great move by Josh.
Maybe he's got – I'm telling you, guys, these guys watch the stream. They know what
even while
talking.
Playing, they
Frank
watch
is gonna
the
make
stream.
This, right? Come on, Frank. I called that. One thing that Josh said, too, talking about spending his summer with Kyle Lowry. Now, they don't play the same position or anything, but Kyle Lowry's won a championship. He's been to the top of the mountain. What can Josh learn from a vet like Kyle?
Well, the good thing about Kyle is he's been an all-star. He's played at a high level. And he's done it, and he wasn't always a superstar. You know, he is now, but he wasn't when his first few years in the league. So I just think not only the patience, but also the work ethic to get to the level that he wants to get to.
Oh, my Lord. Putting on a show.
Nico, is Josh going to start or what? What's the deal, man? Come on.
That's Jay Kidd's call, not mine.
Come on.
Well, the fans seem to want it right now.
All right, well, we appreciate you so much, man, for taking some time with us. Thank you for hanging out. And,
thanks, guys. I enjoyed it.
If you want to join the chat in the second half, twitch.tv/DallasMavericks.
All right, perfect.
Hey, thank you, Nico. Appreciate you, man.
Appreciate you.
There he goes, Nico Harrison.
There
how cool
he
is
goes.
That?
That was awesome. Josh Green absolutely putting on a show out here at Fan Jam. That was incredible. Thank you again, Nico. Thank you, Scooter.